For the first time, Professor Naidu taught them how to cook the rice and how to eat the rice and prepare a curry also. So this is one of the important expeditions of Professor Naidu in his career, and he has got the Commendation Award for the Republic Day in the year 1998. Towards south, we have the Biosphere Reserve of Great Nicobar Island. It is an important island where the Shompen population are inhabiting, and the Shompens are distributed the Great Nicobar Island in different parts, which you can able to observe here. And this is the Campbell Bay, the headquarters of the Shompen population.
Great Nicobar Island is an integral part of the biodiversity of India. The reserve is the home and of the endangered tribes of India, the Shompen. The endangered species like megapod and edible nest swift also resides in this reserve. The island covers virgin, lavish green, dense tropical forest.
Apart from the rich flora, the Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve also houses several species of fauna that attract a large number of visitors every year. The most unique fauna of this biosphere reserve include the crab-eating macaque, saltwater crocodile, giant leather-back turtle, Malayan box turtle, Nicobar tree shrew, Nicobar megapod, reticulated python, and great robber crab.
The banning such of plant series. Presently I am in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Now I am in Great Nicobar Island. In such of the Shompen population, we have first expedition in 1993 with the financial assistance of the Ministry of Environment and Forest, where I have enumerated the Shompen population as 183 individuals. So it has been submitted to the report, was submitted to the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and also to the Government of India for their conservation. Now we have
different kind of ships which are going to the Great Nicobar Island, Grand Nicobar and the Andaman Islands. Here, which I have used in 1993 onwards, we have very few ships, such as Daring, Sentinel, Jarva. These are the three ships which are available to go for the Nicobar Islands. To reach the Great Nicobar Island is a very difficult job. It requires 3 nights and 2 days to travel.
Parts of the Great Nicobar Island. They are food gatherers and hunters and semi-nomadic. They have their own way of life, their primitive way of life. This assists in economies, food gathering, hunting, collecting of fooders and foods. Many of them still living on their own sections of the economy. They are inferior members. It is very difficult for them to approach. It took for me more than 3 months to approach them at different parts of the Great Nicobar Island and my expeditions. Even with the fruitfulness that I can able to document and I can able to write on them their ethnographic reports, both biological and cultural reports, which facilitated and helped us. Many of the administrators and policy makers take the decision how to conserve this Shompen population.
South, we have the Biosphere Reserve of Great Nicobar Island. It is an important island where the Shompen population are inhabiting, and the Shompens are distributed the Great Nicobar Island in different parts, which you can able to observe here. And this is the Campbell Bay, the headquarters of the Shompen population. The existence of the Shompen was first reported by Pastor Rosen, a Danish missionary, in 1831. In 1846, Admiral Steve Bale made the first record visit when the islands were annexed by the British government. Mr. D. Ropstaff, officer in charge, made 3 visits. Great Nicobar is the southernmost of the Bay Islands, lies between 6.45 and 7.15 degrees north latitude and 93.58 and 93.55 east longitude. It is the largest in the area among the Nicobar group of islands, with an area of 1,045 square kilometers, with a length of 55 kilometers between Murray Point in the north and Pygmalion Point in the south. The Pygmalion Point, that is Indira Gandhi Point, the southernmost boundary of India, is about 144 kilometers from Aching Head of Sumatra.
Research on potent geography of Eastern Asia is the first research work which has been taken up by Jirenin, which you can observe here, first geographer who has mapped the Great Andaman and Nicobar Islands. This is the first map which has been done in 1897.
Edward Harris Mann is one of the important ethnographer who has written on the tribes of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Here you can see the Edward Harris Mann, first published in 1883, which is titled as The Aboriginal Inhabitants of Andaman Islands. Here, he has given a detailed account of these tribals, ethnography. That is, you know, he has given about the magic and witchcraft, which is very important to know, the tribal distribution and the tribal community, the nomadism, habitation and adoption relationships. The
1903, Boren Claus made an expedition to Nicobar Islands. He studied about the flora and fauna and the people of Great Nicobar Island. According to him, the Shompen village in Pullakunji inhabited by open shrub and jungle. The Shompen are split into 2 divisions. The larger, who inhabits the interior forests, were hostile. The other, Mawa Shompen, who form settlements near the coastal villages, are quiet and friendly. The Census of India 1921 states that Shompens of Jubilee, Dagmar and Alexander River basins were friendly. They are naked except a bark cloth cover in their shame. They found only men their camps. Their women and children are run away to hide themselves. The Shompens of Galatia River are very wild and hostile. The Shompens of Dagmar River, both men and women were sick, but in other areas they were strong, tough and weary. Generally women appeared weak. They are also darker than the Nicobaris.
The history of our relations with the Andamanese is one of the important document which has prepared by M.V. Portman. This is a basic report which you can observe here. He has talked about the Great Andamanese, Wongis and the Shompens of Great Nicobar Island also. So it's one of the important book. The people, you know, Bonington has taken a lot of pains to prepare this map, the people where they are inhabiting.
Bonington has given a detailed description of the Great Nicobar Island, the rivers, the mountains and the dwelling places of the population in the Great Nicobar Island.
And he has given the population also figures, how many people are inhabiting it. The tribals, the Shompens 200, other tribal Nicobaris 9,281. Written by Frederick J. Mount. Is one of the important book on Andaman Islands. The book was first published in 1863. You can see the sketches, group of Andaman Islanders with the bow and arrows, you can see here.
So in this book,
The Shompen are a distinct population living on the earth who remained virtually isolated, untouched by modern civilization. The Shompen inhabiting zones in Great Nicobar Island should be conserved and protected from the intrusion of the people from both India and foreign. The Shompen are extremely disciplined people. If we cooperate, the hunter-gatherer Shompen have every chance of surviving as hunter-gatherers and as well with us. There is an urgent need to prepare these documents to look into the health status of the Shompen, prepare a detailed ethnographic report, and an action plan should be developed for the conservation of the Shompen population. As the Shompen are biologically, genetically, culturally a distinct population living on the earth, it is the duty of all of us to save this aboriginal population before they extinct from the planet. The need of the hour is to take the advice of a true anthropologist who has dedicated his life for the welfare of the tribes of Andaman and Nicobar Islands and India.